بسم الله، ان شاء الله we can solve the first best paper in statistics May June 2022 variant 1. Yes, variant 1. Number 1. 1A. Can you read?
Find the number of different arrangements of the 8 letter in the word deceived in which all 3 E's are together and 2 D's are together.
Yes, I need all E's together and D's together.
Yes.
How many E's do we have?
We have 1, 2, 3.
We have 3 E's. So, I'll keep them together.
Okay.
As like one letter.
Yes.
And we have 2 D's together.
Yes.
As one letter. Then we have 3 more.
C, V,
and I.
Yes.
Okay. So we can consider that we have how many letters in all?
We have 5.
By how many ways you can arrange them?
5 factorial.
So 5 factorial. You can find the answer. 5 factorial equal 5 times 4, 20 times 3, 60. 60 times 2, 120.
120.
You can check.
Yes.
5 times 14. Okay. Now this 1A. 1B?
Yes. Find the number of different arrangements of the 8 letters in the word deceived in which the 3 E's are not all together.
Not together. Mm. Not all together. Not all together. So we can find number, the total number, without any restriction, minus they will be together, okay?
Yes.
So, if 3 E's together,
then
we have 3. Yes, as one letter, 3 E's.
And other 6.
And we have 5 left.
Five.
D, D, C, V, I. So we are 6 in all.
Yes.
Okay? By how many ways?
We are 6 factorial.
6 factorial.
Yes.
Divide. Because we have 2 repeated, D and D.
Yes.
So divide by 2 factorial. This by how many ways 3 E's will be together. Okay?
Okay.
Now in general, if we have 8 letters in all. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So by how many ways we can arrange them?
8 factorial.
Divide. Because we have repeated.
Yes.
E repeated 3 times. D repeated 2 times.
So 3 factorial times 2 factorial.
Times 2 factorial, yes. Now I need 3 E's not together.
So minus.
So subtract. Okay. Now you can find the answer. Use your calculator. Find the answer. If you subtract.
We get -7/3
minus 6 factorial over 2 factorial.
Oh, sorry.
So the answer?
3,000.
3,000.
6 men and 8 women in our book club. The committee of the club consists of 5 of its members. Mr. Lan, Miss Lan, and are member of the club. In how many different ways can the committee be selected if exactly one Mr. Lan and one Miss Lan must be on the committee?
Exactly one of them.
So there is how many in total? 14 in total, 8 women, 6 men.
Yes, we have 14 in all.
Yes.
But we have 6 men and 8 women.
So we have.
We need to choose 5.
You have to do binomial.
This permutation. We need to choose 5.
Oh, okay, still. We have to
see. But we need for Mr. Lan and Miss Lan, we need one of them included. One of them, exactly one of them included. If Mr. Lan included, okay, so we need to choose the other 4 from the rest. Am I right?
Yes.
So we need to choose 4 from what? No, we cannot include Miss Lan with us.
Oh yes, so 7 women.
So yes, so 5 and 7. So in all we have 12. So we need to choose from 12, we need to choose how many? 4. We need to choose 4 because we need to choose. So Mr. Lan included now. And we need to choose 5. Okay? So we need to choose 4 more. But 4 more include, yes, exclude Miss Lan. So we have 12 in all. So 12C4. Same. If Miss Lan included.
So now 4, 5.
So it's the same, 12C4.
Yes, 5 men and.
Because yes, exclude Mr. Lan from there. So 12C4 plus 12C4. Okay? Or 12C4 times 2.
990.
990. Okay? Now next.
In how many different ways can the committee be selected if Ms. Lan must be on the committee and there must be more women than men on the committee?
Okay. Must be more women in the committee. Okay.
So
Ms. Lan included.
Yes. So to have more, we have 5 in total we can choose?
Yes, we need to choose 5 in all.
So we need to have always women more than men.
Okay.
So we can have 4 women, 1 man, 5 women, 0. Starts from 5.
We include Miss Lan with us.
Okay. So,
so we need, we can choose 4 more. 4 more. So 4 women.
And 0 men.
Yes, and 0 men. And or?
3 women, 1 man.
3 women, 1 man.
No.
Yes, or 2 women. Because 2 and Miss Lance, we have 3 in all.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
And in this case, we need to choose 2 men. Okay?
No more.
No more. Okay. For the first one, we need to choose 4 women from?
5.
We have how many women in all?
In
we have 8. Exclude Miss Lan. So we have 7. So we need to choose 4 from 7.
So
7C4. So 7C4.
Yes.
Next, we need to choose 3.
3 women, yes.
So 7.
Seven.
C3.
Three.
And we need to choose 1 five. From
5.
We have, yes, we have 5. We have 6.
6. Sorry.
Okay?
Yes. So
6C1. 6C1.
Yes.
Okay? Then, if we need to choose 2, so 7C2, okay?
6C2.
Times 6C2. We need to add all. Add them. Tell me the answer. So, total? 560.
Yes.
Number 3. Read number 3.
This time taken to travel to college by 2,500 students are summarized in the table. Draw a histogram to represent this information.
Okay. How to draw a histogram?
You will take the class width. We have to use the formula class.
Yes. We need to find the class width and we need to find the frequency density.
Yes.
Because it's the height. Okay. We can find the class width here.
Yes.
Okay. So class width is equal?
20 for first.
Yes, 20.
10.
30 minus... 20, 10, 40 minus 30, 10,
20,
20 30. Then we can find the frequency density.
Yes, frequency divided by class width.
Yes, the frequency density. You need to divide, yes, frequency by class width.
Yes.
Divide the frequency by the class width.
Because so
frequency density equal frequency divided class width.
Yes.
Now, for the first one, 440 divide 20.
22. Second one, 72.
72.
92.
92.
115, I think.
15. 4. 120 divide 34.
Yes.
Okay. So the maximum number, the maximum 92.
92.
Okay.
So we can go in 20.
So if we go 20, 0, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100
no
oh yeah it does work okay or 0 10 20 same okay so it does work what's the problem we can do that
yes
so now x axis and y axis
so y axis will be frequency density x axis will be time
or yes
whichever one you need to give
frequency density represented on y axis
yes
x axis okay and this y axis okay now for x axis what is the interval till 90
yes
till 90 so okay 0 10 20 30 40 50 60 70 80 90
same.
Oh yes
20
so 0
to 20
10 oh we can write 20
then what's the
40
okay.
60 80 100 same 20 40 60 80 100 okay now for the first group
first one class
from 0 to 20 and height 22
yes
from 0 to 20 and height 22 0 to 20 and the height 22 each small square because from 0 to 10 we have 5 square so each small square represent 2 okay so 22 one more square one small square up okay so from 0 to 20 like that okay this is the first rectangle second one 20 to 30 72 20 to 30, 72. 20 to 30, this 30 is a halfway between 20 and 40.
Yes.
72, this 70.
Yes.
So 72, one more square.
Yes.
So 72, and like that. We can use ruler, it's better.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the second rectangle. Next one. From 30 to 40, 92. 30 to 40, 92. This 90, 92. So 92. Yes.
Okay.
Of course, you need to use ruler.
Yes.
It's better in a proper way. From 40 to 60, 15. 40, 60, 15. 40 to 60, 15. 15.
So,
this 10. And so 2 square and half.
Yes.
2 square and half. 40 to 60.
Yes.
Next one.
Next one.
30. So 60 to 90, 4.
Yes.
60 to 90, 4. Four just two small square.
Just two small
square. Oh, sorry. 60. Till 90.
Yes.
If not accurate.
Now no need to shade, yes? No shade.
No need. Okay. Why you shade? Now this is the histogram.
Yes. Calculate.
B, from the data estimate the mean value. Of t from the data the estimate mean of value of t 31.44 calculate the estimate of standard deviation so we need to find standard deviation we have the mean
yes.
We need to find standard deviation standard deviation how to find standard deviation
summation x over n or square
wait we have the frequency distribution so
yes.
Sigma yes this frequency distribution
Oh, yes, okay. Then we
this frequency, we need to find the center.
Then we have to use fx squared.
Okay.
Yes.
So we need to find the center now.
First we
can make
table.
the formula, if you need the formula, square root summation f x squared over summation f minus the mean, it's given to you now, okay, squared. Now we have the mean 31.44. Okay, so we need to find summation f x squared.
Yes.
Summation, because summation f we have. Summation
yes.
f,
yes.
the mean is given to you, 31.44.
Yes.
And summation f we have.
We
2500.
Yes.
2500.
Now
so we need to sign to find summation f x square. Summation f x square. So from the table.
So
now to find summation f x square, we need to find x. X is the center for each group.
Yes.
From 0 to 10, the center, 20 plus 0 over 2, so 10.
Yes.
Okay? Second group from 20 to 30, so 25.
Yes.
From 30 to 40, 35, that's the center.
Yes.
From 40 to 60, 50. From 60 to 90,
75.
75. This x, okay?
Yes.
Now we need to find summation fx square. So f 440 for the first group, times 10 square, plus, you can do that, 720 times 25 square, plus 920 times 35 square, plus 300 times 50 square, plus 120 times 75 square. 3046 Okay, so now apply the formula.
Yes.
So sigma equal
square root.
Okay.
Yes.
Square root.
This
number
over
2500.
Minus
you have the mean, which is 31.44. Or square. What is the answer?
15.16, which equals 15.2.
15.16 to three significant figure, 15.2.
Yes.
Now,
in
see?
Which interval does the upper quartile lie?
Okay. How do you know that in which class upper quartile lie?
We take maximum value of frequency.
We need to find the order of upper quartile. 3 over 4
okay.
multiply the total of the frequency. Which is 2500
yes.
equals what? This is the upper, the order for upper quartile.
1875.
1875?
Yes.
Okay. So, how to know which class in?
So, now we go to the
order for the upper quartile for Q3 is 1875. Okay? Now it's better to find the cumulative frequency.
Yes, much easier than this.
Yes. 440, this is the first one.
Should I
now add 440 plus 720.
We get, sorry, one second. We get
1160. So till now, not included. Now 1160 plus 920.
2080.
Sorry?
2080.
Now include it, because 1870 included in the third one.
Yes.
So we need to write the cumulative frequency. So the first one, 440.
Yes.
The second till 1160, till now the upper not included. The third one include till 2080, the term which is order 2008. So the upper quartile included in this one, from 30 to 40, from 30 to 40. So, from 30 to 40, okay? Oh, less than 40. Yes?
It was last discovered that the time taken to travel to college by two students were incorrectly recorded. One student's time was recorded as 15 instead of 5, and the other's time was recorded as 65 instead of 75. Without doing any further calculation. insisted whether the estimate of standard deviation in part B will increase, decrease, or stay the same.
Okay. So one of them, instead of
15, you made 5.
Yes, instead of 15, you wrote 5. And the other one?
No, instead of 5, we recorded 15.
Oh, wait.
One student time was recorded as 15 instead of 5.
Okay. So 15 instead of 5.
Yes. No, 5 okay. Instead of 15.
Same. 15 instead of 5.
Okay.
Yes. Okay? So they wrote 15. But the actual 5.
Oh, yes. Okay.
This is the real.
Yes.
Okay? And the other one?
65 was recorded, but wrote 75.
But the actual 75. Okay?
Yes.
So now, does this affect about the standard deviation?
So
go to the table itself. Go to the table. Okay, so 15 instead of 5 and 65 instead of 75. Okay?
So
15 and 5.
If 15, so then.
If you change the set or the class,
yes.
Standard deviation will change because yes. X will change. Standard deviation summation fx squared over summation f divided. So you need to find x. Instead of 15, we wrote 5. Does this affect about the center for this group?
Yes.
Look for this group, from 0 to 20.
Yes.
So 5 and 15 included in the same group.
Oh.
All right, 5 and 15.
Yes.
If 15 or 5 will be included in this group,
yes.
So the center will not change.
Yes?
Yes. From 65 to 75.
No,
65 and 75 also in the same class.
Yes.
So when we find x, we get the same answer.
Mm-hmm.
We get the same answer.
Yes.
Okay? Center will be 75. Same.
Yes. Frequency
okay?
Will also stay same. So it doesn't matter.
No, I talk about x, center.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Because standard deviation calculated from x, summation fx squared over summation f minus the mean squared. So the mean will not change because x will not change.
Yes.
The center of each group will not change. So this means the mean doesn't change and the standard deviation doesn't change because the center will not change. The center will not change. Okay?
Yes.
Because 5 and 15
both
in the first group, 65 and 75 included in the same group.
Yes.
So according to that, standard deviation will be the same. So standard deviation is still the same. Yes, number 4.
Jacob has 4 coins. One of the coins is biased such that when it is thrown, the probability of turning a head is 7 over 10. The other 3 coins are fair. Jacob throws all 4 coins once. The number of heads that is obtained is denoted by the random variable x. The probability distribution table of x is as follows. Show that A equal 1 over 5. And find the values of B and C.
So how to find A? A getting one head, okay? Maybe this head
the
on
biased.
The biased or on the fair, am I right? If it's on the head on the biased,
so then
we need to find A,
yes.
Okay? So to find A, maybe the head on the biased one, probability, so 7 over 10, okay? And what about the 3 coins, the other 3 coins? All of them tail.
Yes, so half.
Half times half times half.
Times.
So half to about
cube.
3.
Half cube.
Okay? Half a cube.
Yes.
But, okay, if we have one head, this head may be, Jacob has 4 coins, one of them, when it throw, it is thrown, the probability of obtaining a head is 7 over 10. The other 3 coins, okay. Throw all 4 coins once. So the number of head that he will obtain is denoted by the random variable x, okay. So if we have the head on the biased one, so 7 over 10. And the other 3 coins, tail. So 1 over 2 times 1 over 2 times 1 over 2 or 1 over 2 power 3. Maybe the head on one of the fair coins. So the probability 1 over 2.
Yes.
Okay? But because we have 3 coins, so if we need one head on the one of the 3 coins, so 1 over 2 times 1 over 2 squared. Multiply 3 because any one of them
can have heads.
Yes. And we have tail on the biased one.
Yes.
So we multiply by 3 because we have 3 fair coins. Any one of them can be can have a head, okay? And we have tail on the biased one. If we add all, we get 1 over 5. What about B? How to find B? We need 2 head.
Yes.
We need 2 head. These 2 head can be on the fair coins or one on the biased and one on the fair.
Same method almost.
Yes. If we have one head on the biased, so 7 over 10.
7 over
10. Okay. And one head
on
one head on the fair, so 1 over 2.
Yes.
So 7 over 10 times 1 over 2.
Times
1 over 2. 1 over 2 squared because tail and tail.
Yes.
But because we have 3 coins, so multiply by 3 because any one of them can have a head.
Any one of them can have tail.
Okay, yes. So this is the first way.
Okay.
Plus, maybe.
Now bias no head.
Yes.
Now bias no head. Now 1 over 2 squared.
So it means the 2 head on the fair one. So 1 over 2 squared.
Yes. Times
1 over 2.
Yes. Times
3
over
10. Times 3 over 10. But also we need to multiply because we have 3. We can choose any 2 of them. By how many ways? By 3. Because 2 is 3C2. This 3C2. So multiply by 3.
Okay.
So get the answer.
For
C, how to find C? We need 3 heads. Yes, we have all.
Yes, so just do this one.
Yes, for C, 1 minus all. 1 minus 3 over 80 plus A, which is 1 over 5 plus B, which is 3 over 8 plus 7 over 80. Then you can get C. Sum of the probabilities is 1. 3 over 10. For B, find EX. We need to find the expectation. Expectation. How to find expectation? Summation X, BX. So you need to multiply X by its probability.
Yes.
So.
So 1 times this, 2 times this.
Yes, we don't need to write multiply 0. So 1 times A, which is 1 over 5. Plus 2 times B, which is 3 over 8.
Yes.
Plus 3 times C, which is 3 over 10.
Yes.
Plus 4 into 7 over 80. This is how to find EX. Now X equal, EX equal what?
11 over
5.
11
over 5?
Yes.
Decimal equal what?
2.2.
2.2, okay.
Yes.
Jacob
throws all 4 coins together 10 times. Find the probability that he obtains exactly one head on fewer than 3 occasions.
Okay.
So we need to do binomial here.
A probability? Yes, binomial, yes. Number of times 10.
Okay.
Okay. B equal what? Probability of getting
probability
one
of head. Getting
head. We have from the table, which is 1 over 5?
Yes, 1 over 5.
So Q equal 4 over 5.
Four.
Probability of getting one head. We did before, which is 1 over 5. And the Q equal 4 over 5 and N equal 10. So we need to find the probability that exactly one head
fewer
than 3. So this means 2 or 1 or 0.
Zero.
Okay?
Not 3. Yes.
Yes. So 10C
0.
2 and 10C 1 and 10C 0.
Yes.
You don't need to 10C 0. 10C
0.
10C 2, this means
10 1 over 5 power 2.
1 over 5 power 2
times 4 over 5 power 8.
Oh, 4 over 5 power 8. Okay. 10C1 times 4 over
5.
Okay. So 10C0 4 over
5
power 10. Then add them.
Okay.
So the answer 0.6783 significant figure. Find the probability that Jacob obtains exactly one head for the first time this geometric distribution. For the first time on the sevens or the eights. On the sevens first.
I forgot geometric.
Okay. So in the sevens means in the first, second, third. No.
You don't get any.
Yes.
Only
so Q power 6 times B. Okay. So 4 over 5 power 6 times 1 over 5. Or in the 8, so Q power 7 times B, so 4 over 5, power 7 times 1 over 5. Then add them. The answer?
0.0944
to 3 significant thing. Okay. Question 5, can you read?
The length in centimeter of the leaves of a particular type of model by distribution N 5.2. 1.5
square. U and sigma square.
Yes. Find the probability that a randomly chosen leaf of this type has length less than 6 centimeters.
Yes. So, how to solve?
So, probability of x less than 6.
Yes. Or directly z less than
6 minus 5.2 over 1.5.
Yes.
Equal a.
So probability of z less than, so 0.5333 and so on.
Yes.
Now we can use the table to find the probability.
Yes, I will tell you.
So the answer?
0.7029.
Okay. If we round to three significant figures, 0.703. Can you read? B, can you read?
The lengths of the leaves of another type are also modeled by a normal distribution. A scientist measures the length of a random sample of 500 leaves of this type and finds that 46 are less than 3 centimeters.
1 minute, 46
are less than 3.
Okay. And?
And 95 are more than 8 centimeters.
So probability? Such that x less than 3,
yes.
We have the number
equal 46.
No,
yes.
Equal 46 over 500.
Yes.
This is the probability. Okay,
yes.
Because the number over the total, and this is the first equation. Second equation,
probability of x greater than 8,
x greater than 8,
yes,
equals.
95
over 500. Now we need to solve this equation.
Yes.
Probability of x less than
3
equal 46 over 500. This number less than half.
You want me to get
so, it? Yes, so we need.
In decimal? You want decimal?
This number less than half. So I need.
So.
Yes, you can convert to decimal. Or 1 minus,
okay.
We can write probability of z less than 3 minus mu over sigma equal 46 over 500.
Yes.
If less than and less than half, this means z negative. So how to find z?
1 minus?
Yes, 1 minus this value. So 1 minus 46 over 500. Can you find as decimal?
Yes, 0.908.
Okay, the three significant figure or four? You can find the answer to four significant figure.
Yes.
So what is the answer for four significant figure?
This
more accurate?
0.9080.
080, okay. Now, this is the probability. we need to find z corresponding to this value. So use the table to find z corresponding to this value. Then after you find z, just write negative because z negative, because we agreed that less than and less than half, this means z negative. Okay, then equate by 3 minus mu over sigma, and we can find equation in terms of u and sigma. Okay,
yes.
So use the table to find the value for z which is corresponding to this probability. So the answer 1.329, but negative because less and less half,
yes.
So negative. So we can write the equation.
So
the equation multiply by sigma. So 3 equal negative mu go to the other side by positive. So mu minus 1.329.
Yes.
This is the first equation.
1.329 sigma.
Yes, sorry. Sigma. Okay. Now second equation, we can do the same for the second equation.
Yes, sir.
Now same for the second equation,
yes.
Probability of x more than 8.95 over 400. This is less than half, so more and less than half. So z positive in this case. So to find z, same.
Yes.
Probability of z more than 8 minus mu over sigma. Equal 95 over 500.
Yes.
So 1 minus 95 over 500 equal upsilon.
Yes.
8 minus mu over sigma.
Mm-hmm.
So can you find this in decimal?
Yes, 0.81.
81.
00.
00, exact. Okay, so find the value for z which is corresponding to that one.
Okay.
So the value for z which is corresponding equal
0.878.
878 equate by 8 minus mu over sigma. Now find the equation. So sigma multiplied to the other side. So 8 equal
mu
plus 0.878 into sigma. Now this is the second equation. We can solve them simultaneously. We can subtract. If you subtract, you can eliminate mu, then you can find sigma. Later, you can solve for sigma. Solving them simultaneously, we can find that sigma is
2.27
and mu
is
6.01 to 3 significant figure.
Okay.
See?
In a random sample of 2,000 leaves of this second type, how many would this scientist expect to find with lengths more than 1 standard deviation from the mean?
Okay. 1 standard deviation from the mean. So if we draw the normal distribution, this is a normal, this is mu. So 1 standard deviation, so 1 sigma from the mean. So this is mu plus sigma. And this is mu minus sigma. So I need 1 standard deviation from the mean. How many would the scientist expect to find with lengths more than 1 standard deviation from the mean? So I need this region, 1 standard deviation from the mean, to the right or to the left. So I need this region. Okay. I need this region or that one. Okay.
Yes.
So we need to find the probability for this one and that one, add them, then multiply by 2,000 to find how many one. Okay.
Yes.
Now to find this one, just like z, x. Okay, so if we subtract mu and divide by sigma, we get 1.
Okay.
For z, to find z.
Yes.
Because to find z minus mu over sigma. Now this is x for you. and that one x. Also, if you subtract mu and divide by sigma, you get negative 1. You get negative 1. So I need a probability to find the probability z more than 1 plus probability such that z less than negative 1. Probability of z more than 1, z more than positive. So this means 1 minus psi 1. You can find psi 1 from the table. Probability of z less than negative 1. Also 1 minus psi 1. So if we add, we get 2 minus 2 psi 1. Now we can find psi 1 from the table. So 2 minus 2 times 0.8413. Yes, what is the answer?
0.3174.
Now this is the probability. We have the number, which is 2000, to find expected number, we have to multiply.
Yes.
So the number 0.3174 times 2000 equal 634.8. You can round to 635 or 634. Yes. Accepted also. Okay, number 6, can you read? Speak up.
Janice is playing a computer game. She has to complete level 1 and level 2 to finish the game. She is allowed at most 2 attempts at any level. For level 1, the probability that Janice completes it at first attempt is 0.6. If she fails at her first attempt, the probability that she completes it at the second attempt is 0.3. If Janice completes level 1, she immediately moves on to level 2. For level 2, probability that Janice completes it at first attempt is 0.4. If she fails at her first attempt, the probability that she completes it at the second attempt is 0.2. Show that the probability that Janice moves on to level 2 is 0.72.
Yes. So, to move level 2, so she need to complete level 1. So what is the probability to complete level 1? In one attempt or two attempts? In one attempt?
0.6.
Because it's written. Yeah. Okay. In the first attempt, 0.6. If she fails at the first attempt, the probability?
That she does it, 0.3.
Okay. If she fails, the probability, if we draw, you can draw a tree diagram. So if she complete in the first attempt, 0.6. Not complete in the first attempt, so 0.4. Now, if not complete in the first attempt, so the second attempt, to complete the second attempt, 0.3.
Yes.
So not complete, 0.7. So to complete in the first attempt, 0.6. In the second attempt, 0.4 multiply 0.3. 0.4 multiply 0.3, so 0.72. Now B?
Find the probability that Janice finishes the game.
So complete the two levels.
Yes.
So we can draw three diagram to help us. So for the first...
You can only draw for level 2, sir.
Yes. For level 2?
Yes.
Okay. For level 2? The probability to complete in the first attempt, 0.4, okay? Or 0.6 to not complete in the first attempt. If she not complete, in the second attempt, 0.2, so this 0.8, to complete or not complete, okay? Now this for level 2. To complete the first level, level A, 0.72. Now, after she completes the first level, maybe she can complete the second level in the first attempt or the second attempt. Okay?
Yes.
So, to finish the game, 0.72. Multiply by 0.4 if she did level 2 in one attempt, or so plus 0.72 times 0.6 times 0.2 if she will complete the second level or level 2 in 2 attempts. So you can find the answer.
This is 0.3744.
0.3744. Now see.
Find the probability that Janice fails exactly one attempt given that she finishes the game.
Okay. This conditional because it's given. Now we have find the probability that Janice fails exactly one attempt. So this for us A. Given that she finishes the game, this B. So probability of A given B is a conditional equal probability of A intersect B divide probability of B. Probability that she finished the game, we did that.
Yes.
So what is the answer for that one?
0.3744.
Okay. Now we need to find the probability of A intersect B exactly fails exactly in one attempt given that and finish the game exactly in one attempt. Now the probability that fails exactly in one attempt and finish the game, one attempt maybe fails in exactly in one attempt, so maybe fails in level 1 or level 2.
Yes.
If she fails on level 1, this means 0.4 multiply 0.3.
Yes.
Okay. And pass. Succeed in level 2, pass in level 2, so 0.4 times 0.3 times
0.4.
Okay, so 0.4 multiply 0.3, this means fail in the first level, multiply, or we can include them in one. 0.4 times 0.3 times 0.4. Or she fails. In second, so 0.6 times 0.2 multiply 0.6, so plus 0.6 times 0.6 times 0.2. Okay.
Yes.
So exactly, fail exactly in one attempt, maybe this will happen in level 1. Then multiply that one, or in level 2, then multiply 0.6. So you can find the answer 0.321, 3 significant figure.
Yes.
Now we need to add.
Yes, so this is 0.7029.
We need to add 10.
Yes.
So 0.7029.
Yes.
Number which is closer to 0.9080, 0.9066, which is corresponding to 1.32. Now we need to add 14. How to add 14? Look for 1,000 digit. Add 14 if you have 9 in. So the answer? 1.329. So we need to find the area which is closer to that one.
Yes.
The closest one, 0.8078, which is corresponding to 0.87. But we need to add
22.
We need to add 22. How to add 22? 0.878.
Yes.
0.878. Upside one, 0.8413.